Good evening. How's everyone doing this evening? Good. Thanks so much for coming out, spending your Saturday evening with us. We have a great program for everyone tonight. As you can see in your program, we have a very eclectic program. And we have some familiar tunes, we have some new tunes, we have some Bach, we have some Dvořák, we have some Saint-Saëns, we have some organ, we even have some harp. So we have a great, great program. This evening we'd like to begin with Brother James Eyre. This is a very familiar hymn tune to many of us. It was written by a Scottish composer, and it evolved in one of the most popular hymns. Our arrangement this evening was arranged by Dr. James Bingham and also Dr. Virginia Jean Rittenhouse, who both were faculty members at WAU. So it's just a real privilege to play their arrangement. This evening's solo will be played by my colleague and good friend, Dr. Preston Hawes. He's also the conductor of the orchestra and also a fantastic violinist as well. So I hope you enjoy this evening. Thank you.
Just a very quick note about the next piece you're going to hear. If you're not familiar with Dvořák, he was actually a composer that from Europe who came and spent a lot of time here in America. And I was reading an article the other day about him and how, in some ways, he introduced American music to America. He really latched on to Americana and was able to create a musical language that became quite iconic. In fact, the very beginning of this movement from the New World Symphony, you'll notice that there are certain themes that you might recognize, but one that struck me is the very beginning of it sounds like Jaws, not that the theme, the Jaws, not that Dvořák wrote that, but it became so iconic that the themes that you hear throughout, sprinkled throughout, have become represented in a lot of American culture. So I hope you enjoy this. The students have worked very, very hard on this piece, and it is quite exciting. If you recognize one of the melodies, please look it up on Google, see if you can find out where else you might have found it from, because you'll find this web of interesting connections.
Thank you.
while they're getting set up for the next solo. Orchestra, obviously, and the students during the pandemic could not rehearse together. And, you know, in a regular four-year cycle, or sometimes five-year, depending on the program, of course, you'll have an incoming class and an outgoing class. So there's always at least 3.5 years of experience playing together before the new group comes in. It's been a very different experience for us to come in kind of cold, having over 2 years of freshmen having not played together, a large graduating class 2 years in a row leaving, it's been a challenge to find that groove again. But you know, these concerts are such great experiences, not just for us as directors, to be able to showcase all the hard work that the students are doing, but it really gives them a chance to perform together in front of people and experience what was missing for 2 years. So we're very grateful that you came out tonight. It's my pleasure to introduce two soloists, Daniel and Sam. They are going to be playing a piece by Bach, second movement, from a concerto for oboe and violin. And you'll note that the orchestra does almost nothing. It's just the soloists that carry you through this. It's really nice to be able to lean back into the tradition of bringing student soloists to the forefront. So I hope you enjoy this.
have some talented students. Sam and Daniel, fantastic. One of the things we try and do in our department is we try and highlight underrepresented composers. Our next piece is by Jessie Montgomery, and the piece is entitled Overture. This was actually just written. It was premiered in May of this year, May of 2022, with the Chicago Symphony. So I believe, if my research serves me correctly, we are only the second orchestra to perform this piece. It's a fantastic piece. Jessie Montgomery is a very talented musician. She's played with the New England Symphonic Ensemble too, hasn't she, Preston? Yes, yeah, so she's a very talented musician. What you'll hear some different sounds than what we might have heard in Bach or Dvořák. She tried to capture different American sounds, jazz harmonies, American classical harmonies. And she also juxtaposed these different harmonies together. So sometimes the harmonies aren't as familiar as, say, Bach or Handel or some of the other music that we're familiar with. But it's a very interesting approach that she took in writing this piece. After the overture, we'll conclude with the Saint-Saëns organ symphony. We're excited to be joined by Ms. Novella Otley, who I think some of you are all familiar with. So I hope you've enjoyed your evening with us, and thank you so much for coming out. Oh, one last thing. We have a fantastic, if you enjoyed this evening, I hope all of you did, we have a fantastic Christmas concert, December 2, over in Sligo at 7:30. So we hope to see you there. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you all so, so much for coming out tonight for a brief concert. We wish you a wonderful weekend. And if you wish to support the music department at Washington Adventist University, please do not hesitate to check out our website, places where you can donate or you can volunteer time to help, whatever it is that you feel that you can do. We so much appreciate it. Thank you so much for coming out tonight.